I will praise you, O Yahweh, my Elohim, with all my heart, and I will glorify your name forever. Know therefore that Yahweh your Elohim is Elohim. He is the faithful Elohim, keeping his covenant of love to a thousand generations of those who love him and keep his commandments. Yahweh himself will give you a sign. A virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and will call him Emmanuel. Gabriel said, Miriam, you will give birth to a son, and you, Yosef, are to give him the name Yeshua, because he will save his people from their sins. Raise the war cry, you nations, and be shattered. Listen, all you distant lands. Prepare for battle and be shattered. Prepare for battle and be shattered. Devise your strategy, but it will be thwarted. Purpose your plan, but it will not stand, for El is with us, Emmanuel. Praise you, Father. Thank you, Father. Well, Shabbat Shalom, everybody. I want to thank each and every one of you for being faithful while Rabbi's gone. Thank you, Father. Praise you, Father. Where two or three are gathered in His name, He said He would be in the middle of us. Praise you, Father. Now, we're going to go ahead and do the liturgy like we normally would. We're just not going to do the part of donning the tallit. You know what? I forgot to give out the readings. The fear of Yahweh is the beginning of wisdom. All who follow His precepts have good understanding. To Him belongs eternal praise. Praise Yahweh, my soul, Yahweh, my Elohim. You are very great. You are clothed with splendor and majesty. Yahweh wraps Himself in light as with a garment. He stretches out the heavens like a tent. And we're going to skip that one. I was glad when they said to me, "Let us go into the house of Yahweh." I will exalt you, Yahweh, for you lifted me out of the depths and did not let my enemies gloat over me. Yahweh, my Elohim, I called to you for help, and you healed me. You, Yahweh, brought me up from the realm of the dead. You spared me from going down to the abyss. Sing the praises of Yahweh, His faithful people. Praise His holy name. For His anger lasts only a moment, but His favor lasts a lifetime. Weeping may last only for a night, but joy comes in the morning. When I felt secure, I said, "I will never be shaken." Yahweh, when you favored me, you made my royal mountain stand firm, but when you hid your face, I was dismayed. To you, Yahweh, I called. To Adonai, I cried for mercy. What is gained if I am silenced, I said. If I go down to the abyss, will the dust praise you? Will it proclaim your faithfulness? Hear, Yahweh, and be merciful to me. Yahweh, help me. You turned my wailing into dancing. You removed my sackcloth and clothed me with joy, that my heart may sing your praises and not be silent. Yahweh, my Elohim, I will praise you forever. Ma Tovu. How lovely. All together. It says, Ma Tovu. altogether. The Israelites are to observe the Sabbath, celebrating it for the generations to come as a lasting covenant. It will be a sign between me and the Israelites forever. For in 6 days Yahweh made the heavens and the earth, and on the seventh day he rested and was refreshed. Let us all rise and face Jerusalem. Is one. You shall love Yahweh your Elohim with all your heart and with all your soul and with all your strength. And these words which I command you today shall be in your heart. You shall teach them diligently to your children and shall talk of them when you sit in your house, when you walk by the way, when you lie down, and when you rise up. You shall bind them as a sign on your hand, and you shall as frontlets between your eyes. You shall fix them as a mezuzah on the doorpost of your house and upon your gates. And you shall love your neighbor as yourself. Okay, we'll remain standing for the Netzarim Amidah. Baruch atah Yahweh Eloheinu, melech haolam, asher natan lanu et derecha, Yeshua, b'meshuach, Yeshua. Altogether, blessed are you, Yahweh, our Elohim, King of the universe, who has given us the way of salvation in Messiah, Yeshua. Speedily cause the branch of David, thy servant, to sprout, and let his horn be exalted by thy salvation, because daily do we wait for thy salvation. Altogether, I believe with perfect faith in the coming of Messiah. Ever how long it takes, I will await his coming every single day. Baruch et Yahweh Hamvarach. Bless Yahweh who is to be praised. Blessed be Yahweh who is praised for all eternity. Altogether, remember the Sabbath day to keep it holy. 6 days you shall labor and do all your work, but the seventh day is the Sabbath of Yahweh, your Elohim. In it you shall do no work, you, nor your son, nor your daughter, nor your male servant, nor your female servant, nor your cattle, nor the stranger who is within your gates. For in 6 days Yahweh made the heavens and the earth, the sea and all that is in them, rested the seventh day. Therefore Yahweh blessed the seventh day and made it holy. Therefore the children of Israel shall keep the Sabbath, to observe the Sabbath throughout their generations as a perpetual covenant. This will be a sign between me and you for the generations to come, so you may know that I am Yahweh who makes you holy. Mika Moka, who is like you? O Yahweh among the Elohim, who is like you, glorious in holiness, fearful in praises, doing wonders.
There is none like you among the Elohim.
Yahweh, and there is no deeds like yours. Your kingdom is an everlasting kingdom, and your dominion endures throughout the generations. Yahweh rules. Yahweh has ruled. Yahweh will rule forever and ever. Yahweh will give strength to his people. Yahweh will bless his people with peace. Father of mercy, bestow your favor upon Zion. Rebuild the walls of Jerusalem, for in you alone we trust. Elohim and ruler, high and exalted, master of all the worlds. Baruch Hashem Yahweh. Baruch Hashem Yahweh. Amen, amen, amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Amen, amen. Yahweh, you are holy and your name is holy. And the Holy One praises your name every single day, forever. Blessed are you, the Holy One of Israel. When the ark would travel, Moses would say, Arise, O Yahweh, and let your enemies be scattered, and let them that hate you flee from you. For from Zion will go forth the Torah and the word of Yahweh from Jerusalem. Blessed is he who in his holiness gave the Torah to his people, Israel. For from Zion will go forth the Torah and the word of Adonai from Jerusalem. Blessed is he who gave the Torah to his people, Israel, in his holiness. Come forward, Geraldine, child of the Torah. Forever and ever. This is the Torah which Moses placed before the children of Israel. Behold, a good doctrine has been given to you. My Torah, do not forsake it. Altogether, all that Yahweh has said, we will do and hear. It is a tree of life to those who grasp it, and those who support it are blessed. Its ways are ways of pleasantness, and all its paths are peace. Help us to return to you, Yahweh, then truly shall we return. Renew our days as in the ancient past. Now it is. Can you hear me? Thank you, ladies. That was beautiful. I get a little emotional by the sound of your voices. I am so blessed to, I just love the sound of each and every one of your voices. It just ministers to me so much, so deeply. Each one of them just are music to my ears. I just love it. I tried several different ways of going for this sermon, and I seem to come back to this one all the time, so I'm gonna share this with you. And I named this Take Heed to Your Ministry. And I want to use for one of the texts this morning Colossians 4:17, and it reads, and say to Archippus, take heed to the ministry which thou hast received in Messiah, that thou fulfill it. Shaul had written this letter to the assemblies in and around the cities of Colossae, and among them he addresses a man by the name of Archippus in Laodicea concerning his ministry. I want to use this verse to address you today concerning your ministry. We read in Romans 15:4, for whatsoever things are written aforetime were written for our learning, that we, through patience and comfort of the Scriptures, might have hope. And in 1 Corinthians 10:11, it says, now all these things happen unto them for examples, that they are written for our admonition, upon whom the ends of the world are come. So we in turn can apply, I believe, these scriptures to ourselves today. In the sacred writings, we are told to pay careful attention to ministry and apply ourselves with thoughtful regard. In Matthew 26:41, we read, watch and pray that you enter not into temptation. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak. And in 1 Peter 4:7, it says, but the end of all things is at hand. Be ye therefore sober and watch unto prayer. Also in Mark 13:33, take ye heed, watch and pray. For you know not what the time is. What time? Time for your ministry. Matthew 18:16 tells us that in the mouth of two or three witnesses, every word may be established. So by these verses here, these witnesses, we are told to watch and pray. Hebrews 12:1 reads, therefore seeing we also are encompassed about with so great a cloud of witnesses, let us lay aside every weight and the sin which doth easily beset us, and let us run with patience the race that is set before us. And again in Ephesians 6:18, it says, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all believers. Shaul impels us to diligently keep watch and pray continually. Matthew 24:12 states, "And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold." Now in Matthew 22:37-40, Yeshua says, "Thou shalt love Yahweh thy Elohim with all thy heart, and with all thy soul, and with all thy mind. This is the first and great commandment, and the second is like unto it, thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself. On these two commandments hang all the law and the prophets." So in Proverbs 4:23, we are told to keep thy heart with all diligence, for out of it are the issues of life. Watch for the danger of lukewarmness in the last days, for our hearts will lead us to say that we have no need of anything. For according to Revelation 3:17, it reads, "Because you say, I am rich and increased with goods and had need of nothing, and knows not that you are wretched, miserable, poor and blind and naked." These are harsh words, but true. It's prophesied that's what we will say in the last days. But in Mark 8:36, it says, "For what profit, or what shall it profit a man if he shall gain the world, but lose his own soul?" So we see how we must minister when the Father puts somebody in our path in these last days. 2 Timothy 3:1-5, "This know also, that in the last days perilous times shall come. For men shall be lovers of their own selves, covetous, boasters, proud, blasphemers, disobedient to parents, unthankful, unholy, without natural affection, truce breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, despisers of those that are good." We experienced that today just in this walk. "But denying the power thereof," "that are good, traitors, heedy, high-minded, lovers of pleasure more than lovers of Yahweh, having a form of godliness but denying the power thereof. From such turn away, apathy and carelessness avoid." And I find that harder and harder today, even in my own life, to fight that lukewarmness. In 1 Thessalonians 5:17, we are told to pray without ceasing. Luke 21:36 tells us, "Watch ye therefore and pray always, that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and stand before the Son of Man." For he tells us in Revelation 16:15, "Behold, I come as a thief. Blessed is he that watches and keeps his garment, lest he walk naked and they see his shame." James 1:17 says, "Every good gift and every perfect gift is from above, and comes down from the Father of lights, with whom there is no variableness, neither shadow of turning." And in Romans 11:29, it says, "For the gifts and calling of Yahweh are without repentance." Now remember, we're talking about ministry, your ministry. Now ministry, simply put, is service to others. Being a servant of Yahweh to meet the needs of others. Yahweh freely gives gifts for ministry, but we must receive them. It requires us to reach up with open hands and a willing heart, but they won't become gifts until we receive them. And I was thinking, what is ministry? Ministry is giving when you feel like keeping. Ministry is praying for others when you yourself need prayer. Ministry is feeding others when you, your own soul, is hungry. Ministry is living truth before other people, even when you don't see the results. Ministry is hurting with others when your own hurt cannot be spoken. Again, ministry is hurting with other people when your own hurt cannot be spoken. Ministry is keeping your word even when it is not convenient. Ministry is being faithful when your flesh wants to run away. Now, concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I will not have you ignorant. Now, there are diversities of gifts, but the same Spirit. And there are differences of administration, but the same master. And there are diversities of operations, but it is the same Elohim which works all in all. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit withal. For to one is given by the Spirit the word of wisdom, to another the word of knowledge by the same Spirit, to another faith by the same Spirit, to another the gifts of healing by the same Spirit, to another the working of miracles, to another prophecy, to another discerning of spirits, to another diverse kinds of tongues, to another the interpretation of tongues. But all these work that one and the selfsame Spirit, dividing to every man severally as he wills. For as the body is one and hath many members, and all the members of the one body being many are one body, so also in Messiah. So this is talking about body ministry. But now hath Yahweh set the members, every one of them, in the body as it has pleased him. And I got tickled on that one because I was so pleased that y'all are all here. I really thought about each and every one of you on this one. Now ye are the body of Messiah and members in particular. And Yahweh has set some in the assembly, first apostles, secondarily prophets, thirdly teachers, after that miracles, then gifts of healing, helps, governments, diversities of tongues. Are all apostles? Are all prophets? Are all teachers? Are all workers of miracles? Have all the gifts of healing? Do all speak with tongues? Do all interpret? But covet earnestly the best gifts, and yet show I unto you a more excellent way. Again, love thy neighbor as thyself. For I say through the grace given unto me to every man that is among you, not to think of himself more highly than he ought to think, but to think soberly according as Yahweh has dealt to every man the measure of faith. For as we have many members in one body, and all members have not the same office, so we, being many, are one body in Messiah, and every one members one of another. Having then gifts differ according to the grace that is given us. And in 2 Corinthians 12:9, my grace is sufficient for thee, says Yahweh, for my strength is made perfect in weakness. So having then gifts according to the grace that is given us, whether prophecy, let us prophesy according to the proportion of faith. Our ministry, let us wait on our ministry. And again, what is ministry? Simply serving others. And he that teaches on teaching, or he that exhorts on exhortation. He that gives, let him do it with simplicity. He that rules with diligence, and he that shows mercy with cheerfulness. Follow after love and desire spiritual gifts, but that rather ye may prophesy. And what again is prophecy? But exhortation and edification. For he that speaks in an unknown tongue speaks not to men, but unto Yahweh. For no man understands him, howbeit in the spirit he speaks mysteries. But he that prophesies speaks unto men to edification, exhortation, and comfort. He that speaks in an unknown tongue edifies himself, but he that prophesies edifies the assembly. Again, we're talking about ministry, serving others. I would that ye all spake with tongues, but rather that ye prophesied. For greater is he that prophesies or edifies and exhorts the assembly than he that speaks with tongues, except that he interpret, that the assembly may receive the edifying. Even so ye, for as many as ye are zealous of spiritual gifts, seek that ye may excel to the edifying of the assembly. Let's talk about body ministry, your ministry. We read in 1 Timothy 4, 14 through 16, neglect not the gift that is in thee, which was given thee by prophecy with the laying on of the hands of the minister. Meditate upon these things, give thyself wholly to them, that thy profit may appear to all. Take heed unto thyself and unto the doctrine, continue in them, for in doing this thou shalt save thyself and them that hear thee. Yeshua tells us of a kingdom principle in Matthew 25, 14 through 30. For the kingdom of heaven is as a man traveling into a far country, who called his own servants and delivered them his goods. And he said, and unto one he gave 5 talents, and to another 2, and to another 1. To every man according to his several ability, and straightway took his journey. Then he that had received the 5 talents went and traded with the same and made them 5 more talents. And likewise, he that had received 2, he had also gained 2 others. But he that had received 1 and dug in the earth and hid his master's money. And after a long time, the master of those servants came and reckoned with them. And so he that had received 5 talents came and brought 5 other talents, saying, Master, thou delivered to me 5 talents. Behold, I have gained beside them 5 more talents. His master said unto him, Well done, thou good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over many things. I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of thy master. He also that had received 2 talents came and said, Master, thou delivered to me 2 talents. Behold, I have gained 2 other talents beside them. His master said unto him, Well done, good and faithful servant. Thou hast been faithful over a few things. I will make thee ruler over many things. Enter thou into the joy of thy Lord. Then he which had received the 1 talent came and said, Master, I knew that thee were a hard man, reaping where thou had not sown, and gathering where thou had not scattered. And I was afraid, and I went and hid thy talent in the earth. Lo, there thou hast thine. His master answered and said unto him, Thou wicked and slothful servant, thou knew that I reap where I sowed not, and gathered where I have not scattered. Thou art therefore have put my money to the exchangers, and then at my coming I should have received mine own with interest. Take therefore the talent with him, and give it to him which had 10 talents. For to every one that has shall be given, and he shall have abundance. But from him that hath not shall be taken away even that which he has. And cast ye the unprofitable servant into outer darkness. There shall be weeping and gnashing of teeth. We are told in Luke 12:48, But he that knew not and did commit things worthy of stripes shall be beaten with few stripes. I'm going to repeat that. But he that knew not and did commit things worthy of stripes shall be beaten with few stripes. For unto whomsoever much is given, of him shall be much required. That's why I'm very sober when I get up here. I know that much will be required of me. I don't take this very lightly. As a matter of fact, I get very nervous and sometimes even sick when I'm up here. And to whom many have been committed much, of him we shall ask for more. Remember, we are talking about your ministry. In 2 Timothy 4:5 it says, But watch thou in all things, endure afflictions, don't be easily offended. And the Father showed me something very important about a year or so ago. Because we have to discern between the walking in the flesh and the works of the Spirit. And the Father showed me that if we walk around easily offended, we are walking in the flesh. Because you cannot be offended in the Spirit. For the Spirit is Yahweh. Keep hearing things in there. We do have somebody else among us. Bless his heart. Okay. And whatsoever ye do in word or deed, do all in the name of Messiah Yeshua, giving thanks to Yahweh and to the Father by him. And whatsoever you do, do it heartily, as to the Master, and not unto men. And I have learned to apply that with teaching with my students. And it has made a world of difference for me. I have found that I end up enjoying the day. Because I do it unto the Father. And the Father shows me so many times things that I can minister to those students for. Not just in what I teach them at school, but also in their personal lives. Because we always need something. A word of encouragement, a hug, something. And the Father always shows me how I can reach out to those students. So in Ephesians 1, 9 through 10, we read, having made known unto us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure, which he has purposed in himself, that in the dispensation of the fullness of times, he might gather together in one all things in Messiah, both which are in heaven and which are on earth, even in him. In the life of the believer, it is to be pleasing to Yahweh. It must be properly adjusted in him in all things. Too often we place our emphasis on the application of one principle in our lives and to some single detail of our behavior or of our work for him. But Yahweh measures everything from start to finish by the perfection of his Son. Scripture clearly affirms that it is Yahweh's good pleasure to sum up all things in Messiah Yeshua. So again, we're talking about your ministry. In Deuteronomy 10, 12 through 13, it reads, and now Israel, what does Yahweh the Elohim require of thee? But to fear Yahweh the Elohim, to walk in all his ways, and to love him, and to serve Yahweh the Elohim with all thy heart and with all thy soul, to keep the commandments of Yahweh and his statutes, which I command you this day for thy good, who has saved us and called us by a holy calling, not according to our works, but according to his purpose and grace, which was given us in Messiah Yeshua before the world began. In James 1:22 it says, but be ye doers of the word, and not hearers only, deceiving our own selves. Examine yourselves whether ye be in the faith. Prove your own selves. Know ye not your own selves how that Messiah Yeshua is in you, except you be a reprobate. In 2 Corinthians 13:5, we also read, study to show thyself approved unto Yahweh, a workman that need not be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, that ye might walk worthy of the Master unto all pleasing, being fruitful in every good work, and increasing in the knowledge of Yahweh, according to Colossians 1:10. Knowledge, apart from application, falls short of Yahweh's desire. Knowledge must result in change and growth. Peter urges believers to keep close watch on their personal lives. The life of a believer demands diligence in pursuing moral excellence, knowledge, self-control, perseverance, godliness, blameless, and steadfast. Scripture tells us grace that we know as unmerited power given to man to do Yahweh's will, and to you and peace, shalom, and resting in Yahweh. Be multiplied or abounding by full knowledge of Yahweh our Elohim and Messiah Yeshua our Master. Ephesians 1, 17 through 18 says that the Elohim of our Master Messiah Yeshua, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that you may know what is the hope of his calling and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance are in the saints. We read in Ephesians 4, I therefore, the prisoner of Messiah, beseech you that you walk worthy of the vocation where you were called, with all lowliness and meekness, with long-suffering, forbearing one another in love, enduring to keep the unity of the Spirit and the bond of peace. But unto every one of us is given grace according to the measure of the gift of Messiah. And he gave some apostles and some prophets and some evangelists and some pastors and teachers for the perfecting of the saints, for the work of the ministry, and for the edifying of the body of Messiah, till we all come into the unity of the faith and of the knowledge of the Son of Yahweh, into a perfect man, unto the measure of the stature of the fullness of Messiah. But speaking the truth in love, may grow up unto him in all things, which is the head, even Messiah, from whom the whole body fitly joined together and compacted by that which is every joint supplies, according to the effectual working and the measure of every part, making increase of the body into the edifying of itself in love. Service again, ministry of serving one another. Let us walk worthy before him. In 1 Corinthians 7:17 it says, but as Yahweh has distributed to every man, as the Messiah has called everyone, let us walk. It is evident Scripture states that there are many kinds of ministry. Again, ministry, simply put, is the service of others. But I want to talk again now about a ministry that's so often overlooked, the ministry of one another. And again, I believe this is a ministry that we're all called to. Hebrews 3:13 states, "But exhort one another daily, while it is called today, lest any of you be hardened through the deceitfulness of sin. And let not us be weary in well-doing, for in due season we shall reap if we faint not," according to Galatians 6 and 9. In the 2 Thessalonians 3:13 it says, But ye brethren, be not weary in well-doing. And I have to say that there's been many a times I've come in here weary by the end of the week. And I honestly don't understand how somebody can make it through the week without a Sabbath, without a rest, a day set apart to allow Yahweh to settle upon his people. So I've come in here many a times dragging, and it's by the encouragement of one of you, whether it be a smile or a hug or just an encouraging word that lifts me. And I look so forward to Rabbi's sermons during the Sabbath to give me the strength that I need for the week. But every now and then, I need to see the Father in the land of the living. I need somebody to encourage me, or just a hug. Just a hug. Romans 12:2 states, "And be not conformed to this world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and the perfect will of Yahweh." And in 1 Thessalonians 5:11, "Wherefore comfort yourselves together and edify one another." And in Colossians 3:16, we read, "Let the word of Messiah dwell in you richly in all wisdom, teaching and admonishing one another in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing with grace in your hearts to Yahweh. Him that is weak in the faith receive ye, but not to doubtful disputations." In Romans 14:1, "Let us not judge or condemn, but to lift up." In Romans 15:1-3, it says, "We then that are strong ought to bear the infirmities of the weak, and not to please ourselves. Let every one of us please his neighbor for his good to edification. For even Messiah pleased not himself, but as it is written, the reproach of them that reproach thee fell on me." In Galatians 6:1 it says, "Brethren, if a man be overtaken in a fault, ye which are spiritual, restore such as one in the spirit of meekness, considering thyself, lest thou be tempted. For it's only by the grace of Yahweh, there go I." I've said that many, many times. In Hebrews 10:24, "Let us consider one another to provoke unto love and good works." Ephesians 4:32 tells us, "Be ye kind one to another, tenderhearted, forgiving one another, even as Yahweh for Messiah's sakes has forgiven you." For in 1 Peter 4:8 we read, "And above all things have fervent charity or love among yourselves, for charity or love shall cover a multitude of sins." James 5:16 says, "Confess your faults one to another." It seems like I do a lot of that with you guys. "And pray one for another that ye may be healed. The effectual fervent prayer of a righteous man avails much." 1 Thessalonians 3:12, "And Yahweh may make you to increase and abound in love toward one another and toward all men." Finally, "Be ye all of one mind, having compassion one for another. Love as brethren, be pitiful, be courteous," in 1 Peter 3:8. "Speak not evil one of another, brethren. He that speaks evil of his brother and judges his brother speaks evil of the law and judges the law. But if thou judge the law, thou art not a doer of the law, but a judge," in James 4:11. Colossians 3:13 says, "Forbearing one another and forgiving one another, if any man have a quarrel against any, even as Messiah forgave you, so also do ye." And I find that the hardest sometimes. In Matthew 6:14-15, we are told, "Forgive if ye forgive men their, for if ye forgive their trespasses, your heavenly Father will also forgive you. But if you forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your Father forgive your trespasses." Matthew 11:6 reads, "And blessed is he whosoever shall not be offended in me." Again, if you walk in the Spirit, you will not be offended. If you are in him, you won't be offended. Psalms 165 says, "Great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them." Proverbs 18:10, "The name of Yahweh is a strong tower. The righteous run into it and are safe." In the Siddur, just before the Shema, we recite the blessing that begins with, "Abounding love, you have loved us." In this prayer, we ask Yahweh to unite our hearts in love and to fear his name. And again, "This is my commandment, that ye love one another as I have loved you," in John 15:12. Galatians 5:13-14, "For brethren, you have been called into liberty," liberty, freedom. "Only use not your freedom for an occasion to the flesh, but to love, serve one another. For all the law is fulfilled in one word, even as this, that thou shalt love thy neighbor as thyself." Again, like Rabbi taught us the other day, we will esteem ourselves lower than others and esteem them higher. We'll be willing to serve them, and we will put them first. And I know sometimes it's hard. I fight it all the time. My personality, I fight it all the time. Galatians 5:19-26. "Now the works of the flesh are manifest, which are these: adultery, fornication, uncleanliness, lasciviousness, idolatry, witchcraft, hatred, variance, emulsions, wrath, strife, seditions, and heresies." Well, I don't do any of those. Well, is any one sin greater than the other, or any less than the other? "Envyings, murder, drunkenness, revelings, and such like, of the which I tell you before, as I have also told you in time past, that they which do such things shall not inherit the kingdom of Yahweh. But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, and faith, meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law." There is no judgment in meekness. There is no judgment in temperance. There is no judgment in love or joy. "And they that are Messiahs have crucified the flesh with the affections and lusts. And if we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not be desirous of vainglory, provoking one another or envying one another." Psalms 119, "Great peace have they which love thy law, and nothing shall offend them." 1 Thessalonians 4:9, "But as touching brotherly love, ye need not that I write unto you, for ye yourselves are taught of Yahweh to love one another." How can we love Yahweh if we don't love one another? Romans 12:10, "Be kindly affectionate one to another with brotherly love, and honor preferring one another." You know, I really honestly don't believe any of us here in this room have a problem with this. It's easy to love each other. It's easy to love you here. It's so easy to love you here. It's when I walk out this door that I fight to apply this to my life. I ask the Father to write it upon my heart. Romans 12:10, "Be kindly affectionate one to another with brotherly love, in honor preferring one another." And it's hard to honor that person and esteem them higher than yourself when they're in your face. That's when I have to cry out, "Father, your grace is sufficient." Because in the flesh, I'm fixing to do something. I'm fixing to do something. 1 Peter 1:22, "Seeing ye have purified your souls in obeying the truth through the Spirit unto unfeigned love of the brethren, see that ye love one another with a pure heart fervently." And Father, that's our desire today, a pure heart before you. 1 Corinthians 13, "Love suffers long and is kind. Love envies not. Love vaunts not itself, is not puffed up. Do not behave itself unseemingly. Seeks not her own, is not easily provoked, thinks no evil. Rejoices not in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth. Bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things." Love will give that other person the benefit of the doubt. You will always believe the best in them. And, you know, I find that it's hard to do that sometimes, especially with excess baggage that we have in our past. We always tend to pull up walls, and we're always suspicious of people. That makes it so hard to trust. But the Father says, do it in me. Do it in me. We've been hurt many times to the point that we ever thought that our heart would feel again. But the Father heals and the Father forgives. But we must forgive to be forgiven. Love never fails. But whether there be prophecies, they shall fail. Whether there be tongues, they shall cease. Whether there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part shall be done away. When I was a child, I spake as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in part, but then I shall know even as I also am known. And now abides faith, hope, and love. These three, but the greatest of these is love. Philippians 2, 3, and 4, let nothing be done through strife or vainglory, but in lowliness of mind, let each esteem others better than themselves. Look not every man on his own things, but every man also on the things of others. Are we not one body? Ephesians 4, 4, there is one body and one spirit, even as ye are called in one hope of your calling. And he is the head of the body, the assembly, who is the beginning, the firstborn from the dead, that in all things he might have the preeminence, in Colossians 1:18. Now ye are the body of Messiah, and members in particular, in 1 Corinthians 12. For the body is not one member, but many. 1 Corinthians 12 tells us that there should be no division in the body, but that the members should have the same care one for another. 1 Corinthians 6:15, know ye not that your bodies are the members of Messiah? Shall I then take the members of Messiah and make them the members of a harlot? Yahweh forbid. When we are sick, do we not remedy the body? If it becomes disease, do we not cut out the disease to keep the body healthy? Matthew 9:12, they that are whole need not a physician, but they that are sick. Many, O Yahweh, my Elohim, are thy wonderful works which thou hast done, and thy thoughts which are with us usward. They cannot be reckoned up in order unto thee. If I would declare and speak of them, they are more than that can be numbered. Sacrifice and offerings thou didst not desire. Mine ears hast thou opened. Burnt offerings and sin offerings thou hast not required. Then said I, lo, I come in the volume of the book, it is written of me. I delight to do thy will, O Elohim. Yea, thy law is within my heart. I have preached righteousness in the great congregation. Lo, I have not refrained my lips, O Yahweh, thou knowest. I have not hid thy righteousness within my heart. I have declared thy faithfulness and thy salvation. I have not concealed thy loving kindness and thy truth from the great congregation. Withhold not thy tender mercies from me, O Yahweh. Let thy loving kindness and thy truth continually preserve me. Ephesians 5:21 says, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of Yahweh. Use hospitality one to another without grudging. Likewise, ye younger, submit yourselves unto the elder. Yea, all of you be subject one to another and be clothed with humility, for Yahweh resists the proud and give grace to the humble. Wherefore, receive ye one another as Messiah also received up to the glory of Yahweh. Owe no man anything but to love one another, for he that loves another has fulfilled the law. Let us all say, as in Ephesians 3:7, wherefore I have made a minister, or wherefore I was made a minister according to the gift of grace of Yahweh, given unto me by the effectual working of his power. And Ephesians 3:16 through 21 says that he would grant you according to the riches of his glory to be strengthened with might by his spirit in the inner man, that Messiah may dwell in your hearts by faith, that ye be rooted and grounded in love, may be able to comprehend with all saints what is the breadth, the length, and the depth and height, and to know the love of Messiah, which passes knowledge, that ye may be filled with all the fullness of Yahweh. Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly abundant above all that we ask or think, according to the power that works in us, unto him be glory in the assembly by Messiah Yeshua through all ages, world without end. I'm going to close this. I had one little verse that I wanted to close it with. And I know I have been preaching to the choir, and that just thrills my heart to no end. I lost my notes. First Corinthians 16:14 says, let all your things or your ministry be done with love. So I'm going to go ahead and close this. And let's get this over with. Okay, when you have eaten and are satisfied, you shall bless Yahweh your Elohim for the good land which he has given you. Blessed are you, Yahweh our Elohim, the King of all the universe, who created all beings and their needs, for all that you created to sustain these beings. Blessed be the one who lives forever. Blessed are you, Yahweh our Elohim, King of the universe, who nourishes the entire world. In your grace and mercy, you give nourishment to all flesh, for your kindness is eternal. Our compassionate one, through your great goodness, we have never lacked, and may we never lack nourishment for all eternity. For the sake of your great name, you prepare food for all the creatures that you have created. We thank you for your provisions, which you nourish and sustain us constantly, every day and in every season. May your great name, O Yahweh, be blessed by the mouth of all the living, continually for all eternity. Blessed are you, Yahweh, my Elohim, who nourishes all creation. Amen. Let's eat.